contributions of all the participants and the resource persons, a very warm welcome and a very warm, healthy, sweet morning to all, one and all present. You know, why do I use the word healthy? Because under these pandemic conditions of COVID-19, we are here on a new platform, meeting each other in a new way, a new communication way with which we have joined today. And I would like to welcome each one of you. I welcome our Honorable President, sir, in this first technical session for giving me, bestowing me with this opportunity to talk to such a large number of participants and being able to present the ice-breaking session. I would also like to thank our Principal, sir, the staff and the nodal officer, the director, Madam Asha Rani ji, and my own head ma'am, Dr. Sushmanderjeet Kaur, for giving me this opportunity. Now I begin with the ice-breaking session, and the very first thing I would like to ask all the participants that you must have now, by now, already filled the very first form and a very interesting form for which I wanted you to just come out with a few things about yourself. Let's self-introspect today. Let's try to know each other more comfortably and more nicely. Now, the very first question I ask you today, all of you, that come on, let's try and speak two truths about ourselves, which we want to share with our own self, and one lie, which we keep on telling ourselves, yes, I am this, I am that, I am not, and whatever it is. So let's self-introspect in this moment, first of all. As Dr. Dipti Gupta, chairperson of the Department of English and Cultural Studies, just mentioned, and I'm really grateful to her for mentioning this fact, that yes, one needs to communicate, language should not become a barrier. Your language, any language, and for us, you know, our mother tongues may be Hindi, Punjabi, Telugu, Marathi, because we have participants from all over India. So what I would like all of us to be in touch, connect with each other, and language should never become a barrier. We just need to be proficient in the language, in whatever language we are trying to connect with each other. So let's not say just because I'm talking in English, my subject is English, so that let's not that be a way or a, you know, an obstacle in the way we talk and connect with each other. So did you find or did you introspect about the two truths and one lie which you are having, which you think you are having? Now, for communication, I would like to talk about, I would like to start with and poem Fear by Khalil Gibran. You must have all been, you know, must have read that poem. I'm just mentioning a few lines and just reading a few lines, you know. He says, it is said that before entering the sea, a river trembles with fear. Definitely, you know, because a river is much smaller than a sea. But there is no way the river cannot go back. To go back is impossible in existence. Similarly, under these pandemic conditions also, if we say we can only be locked down, staying, you know, just kind of a very vegetative life in our homes, it's not possible. And the best example is what we are doing today. We are connecting with each other through online modes. But what mistakes we make when we move on? The very first one is we move too fast. We think we know everything and we start jumping to the conclusions. We do not wait for us to understand what we need to first learn. And we jump into the pitch. We understand, yes, we've done it, and we jump into the pitch. And the third very important thing and mistake which we do is we start talking instead of listening. We already think we know too much. We have learned too much, and we stop. We stop giving an ear to the experts, maybe the elders, maybe to the colleagues, maybe to the younger ones also, because these days you learn a lot from the new generation, from the coming generation. And then what do? even before, you know, we have built the interest or our interests in a particular thing, we try to close the issue. We say, oh, it's okay, we are done with it, you know. So I know a lot about it, I don't need to go. So what do we do? Now, it's not me, but yes, I've picked it up definitely from somewhere, I will not say. We need to use this face as our meter for managing things. Like, the very first thing is find. We need to find in what are we interested. Are we interested in a particular thing? We're not interested in everything. We all know that, you know. Sometimes I may like something and I may not. So we are definitely, we need to find our areas of interest, our areas of improvement, and then connect. And then connect with what? Connect with what makes us learn about it, what gives us more information about it, and then engage ourselves into thinking about it, into analyzing it, or commenting on it. So face is a way which we can find out what is the new thing. Now, we are living in an society, in an era where there is a perfect storm. Storm, just not economical, you know. How economical? Because we are staying back home. We do not know, you know, it's a complete lockdown for the entire world for the first time, I believe, you know. These economies are at standstill. We are not earning much. There's no business going on. Yes, technologically, we are moving ahead. Like, we've moved up today. We are connecting almost more than 600 people together today, and we're trying to talk to each other, trying to sit and chat with each other, share our knowledge. And culturally, definitely, this era is a multicultural era. We're just not limited to, you know, Punjabi culture or Haryana culture or Himachali culture. We are into a cosmopolitan society where we are adapting each other's cultures, language, and way of even communicating. We are adapting new accents. We are adapting new languages. So what is now the problem? The problem is, whatever used to work earlier, it doesn't work now. It's as simple as that. Because earlier, we used to just be focused about our state, our city, our country. Oh, no. Now, we need to understand and we need to see more of multicultural, or we need to know more people, their interests, their studies. The world has definitely been part of it. We are a part of the change. We are part of everyday change, whatever is happening. And then a new approach is needed. A new approach is needed to look at the world, to know the world. And then beautifully, you know, pictured it here. Earlier, we used to go out, meet, see, and then today, what are we doing? We are meeting through the cell phones, through the laptops, through the emails. So definitely the means of meeting our friends and families have changed, and the lockdown is one of the best examples which God or Providence has shot on us. Now, how can we successfully, you know, master the art of connecting with each other? The very first thing what we need is self-confidence. Definitely, if you need to even talk to one single person, let alone a whole room full of people, it is very important that you need to have self-confidence to stand and face them, to stand and say even a single word to them. And then you must understand the audience which you are facing, the people to whom you are talking. Why? Because if I am, you know, giving you, delivering you this lecture, I understand there are majority of you are teachers, majority of you are academicians, and you will not like the basic kind of information. You will definitely like an expertise lecture, a specialist lecture. You must be enthusiastic. When I say enthusiastic, it means you should be full of energy to say what it means. What is? Because if you are dull, if you are slow, definitely the people who are talking to you or understanding you or listening to you, they automatically go into a slow mode. Then what I am missing is you must make eye contact. You know, I'm talking to you, but I'm unable to see majority of you. So I'm just, you know, it almost feels like as if I'm talking to a blank wall, which is not, you know, my best way of communicating. And then if I'm talking to you, I must be interested in you. That is very, very important. I cannot be talking or communicating to people whom I am not interested, whom I do not want to talk, or whom I do not have my wavelength, mental wavelength, with each other. So I'm not going to bore you with the communication skills, you know, definitions and ways, because that is the expertise of the resource persons coming your way in the next 4 days. I'm just going to share, you know, the basics of connecting, the basics of how we are to deal with each other in such situation as we are caught up these days. Now, communication is a dynamic, it is ever-growing process, it is ever-moving process through which we convey our feelings, our thoughts, our emotions with each other. And it depends upon so many things. I've given you a set of events that is like stimuli. Your energy, the receiver's energy, is as important as the communicator. And the audience is as much important to, and they should be receptive. They should be ready to receive what I am ready to give. And what more plays and important is what you say is very important in your communication. So the total communication process I've divided is, you know, listening. You know, whatever I am saying, I know it is very hard for all of us to listen, you know, because most of us, we are teachers, and, you know, to deliver a 40-45 minutes lecture is very, very easy. But to hear to a person, to listen, or to give a keen full ear to a person for even 10 minutes is pretty hard. So listening in the communication process, I'm giving 45% to it. It is a big amount. Speaking is 30%. Yes, definitely. If I speak good, I impress you with my speaking talent. Definitely, you're going to hear me for a little time. Writing is 9%, because the world is today moving towards communication, and that is less of writing, or, you know, abbreviations of writing. Or we can, I would like to use the cliche term, the internet spellings and the internet writing. And definitely, to do all these things, reading, writing, and listening, you need to read as well. Read information, read books, read newspapers, read articles, and many other modes, whatever you find more interesting. Now, there are many levels of communication, like verbal, the way I'm doing, but intraverbal, you know? Verbal, which we box in sections, and like intraverbal, like intonation and sound. It is implication of words.
Implication of
the sound for my words. Phrases which I use.
Semantics. Semantics.
The level of communication also goes on non-verbal. Like body language, put everything into it. Gestures, the way I am presenting my lecture. Postures, if I'm sitting comfortably, and I'm standing comfortably. Giving a limp, you know. Picture of myself by being not interested, by being very lazy. And my movements. So I make my hands move, make my eyes move, they're all symbolic. And you know, what I believe is that the art of connecting with people begins even before you have said a word to them. You know, your face, your personality is the underlying energy which is with you all the time. If you're energetic, if your personality is very attractive, it is very, you know, I should say positive, you radiate that positivity into the world, and you don't even have to say a word, but you'll see people smiling and coming to you, and That generally happens when you go to a party, you know. If you yourself are receptive and positive in your attitude, people who even do not know you would like to come to you and say hi. Now, what are the problems? You know, problems are both ways, for the communicator who is trying to tell you something as well as for the receiver. So I'm going to just elucidate quickly few problems of the communicator, and that is, you know, if I am unwilling to say things differently, if I'm going to say the things routine, jo roz mein aapko aap kitabon mein aapne padha hua hai, if I'm going to say all those things, you'll not be able to, you're not interested. If I am myself, I'm not going to give you good examples, not given to, you know, give you examples which to which you relate, you can identify, then again, it is my problem. Then unwillingness to learn new approaches. As I said, communication is a dynamic process. So dynamic, if it is an ever-growing, ever-moving process. So if I am not open to new learning, to listen to the new approaches, then I'm a closed person. I have a closed mind, which I will not be able to, you know, be relevant within few days. Then if the communicator does not have self-confidence, enthusiasm, his voice quality is not clear to you, and if I am already prejudiced, you know, for a few things, I will not like to, you know, learn new things, or I will not like to adopt to new, I should say, theories, then maybe again you will not be, the receiver will not be interested. Then definitely, if I project my negative self-image, if I'm open to your feedback, and if I lack motivation and thinking at every level, my language and my vocabulary is not up to the mark, and I'm not conscious of myself, I'm not aware of the new things, definitely you will not like or listen to me or anyone. You know, the communication becomes dull. And once the communication is dull and boring, you will not be happy with the communicator. Then the problems of receiver is that if the receiver only wants to receive his own perspective, then definitely whatever the communicator does, the receiver will not be able to, you know, let anything come into his mind. Then again, similarly, if he's unwilling to change and if he doesn't have any kind of interest on the topic, or if he again is himself prejudiced and doesn't believe into the new things, and then if he has rebuttal instincts, you know, he would like to give you very hurting and, you know, bad answers, and his personal value system is not up to the mark, or he doesn't want to change. So there are a few barriers. Even receiver has to have an open mind with which he can, you know, receive the new information. Now, I've already dealt with it, but I'm again coming back to it. Communication is only 7% words, only 7% vocabulary. It is more of paralinguistic. Now, what is paralinguistic? It is like the way I'm speaking, in the tone which I'm speaking, the accent. You know, if in India I'm pronouncing or I'm using apart from the RP pronunciation, which is prescribed to us, if I'm using another pronunciation, then maybe, you know, you will not be interested. And more of communication is the body language. When I say body language, I've already mentioned eyes are windows to your soul. Our eyes are window to the soul. And if I am not able to connect with you through my eyes, the communicator lacks, you know. And that's what I'm feeling today, that I'm just talking to a board. I am not able to see a lot number of you. And definitely your clothes, your gestures, they all play a part in conveying what you want to convey to the receiver, to your audience. Now, one beautiful message I would like all of you to understand is that each one of us has a beautiful message in our mind, in our souls, and we have a desire to share it. Coming back to Dr. Dipti Gupta's message, please do share it. We all are human beings who have mixed, you know, vices as well as, you know, beautiful, humble messages in ourselves, which kindness and, you know, which we want to share. But just because language being a barrier, we are unable to share it. We are afraid to share it. I request each, all of one of you, that you must share whatever humble, you know, message you have without bothering about the language in which you are proficient. You know, language should not be a barrier. Next, we can also say that, you know, in the conversation or in the communication part, etiquettes are also very, very important. If I am harsh with you, if my body language is cruel to you, rude with you, you will definitely not like to sit a second before me, you will run off. So always make people, you should remember, make the other person who is the receiver of your information on to whom with whom you are communicating, make them feel special, make them feel wanted, you know, and also give them an ear. And you should always avoid negativity. Do not let negativity ever come into your communication barrier. Now, I'd like to give you a beautiful example that what we need to practice in our everyday life. That is, a simple example is a handshake, you know. If I go and shake a hand, which is not, you know, practically possible these days because of the COVID-19, we are told not to shake hands, but to use the way, you know, our salutation should be, you know, by folding our hands. So anyways, even, you know, when we used to hug each other, when we used to shake hands with each other, the energy of our body should shine through that handshake. We should, if you give a limp hand, you know, it feels you're not interested in the man. It shows that you're just, you know, just there out of courtesy. You're just there, or you're meeting that man because you are in a so-called fixed situation and you have to do it. But otherwise, if you want actually to practically communicate with them, your energy should shine. And it just doesn't shine through your through the handshake. It shines through your eyes, your body actions, and your way you meet the person. Now, I would like to add here a few things. That is that conversation is always like, if I'm conversing with you right now, if I'm connecting with you right now, it is meeting of minds, which will leave with us different memories and different, you know, by we shall adopt. If you like something out of my slides, you will definitely adopt, you know, or check into them again. If you do not, you just forget. So conversation, communication, connection is always meeting of minds, and it doesn't reshuffle the cards, but it makes new cards. It is creative. Communication is creative. When we connect with each other, we definitely learn something out of our conversations, out of the connections which we make with each other. And it is, in a way, a beautiful creative exercise, a creativity which we shall definitely remember. And now coming to the things what you are holding on for the next 4 days, I would like to enumerate here a few objectives for which this workshop has been brought before you, or it has been designed this way to be brought before you. Now, the very first thing we want to make you understand is the role of communication in both personal as well as professional successes. You know, a family relationship can be given a death blow. Umar sakda hai agar we talk to each other in bad words, in bad manners, if we don't give pay attention to them, if we are showing them that they are not the right persons, if, you know, even a body language, if it reflects so, you can give a death blow to personal relationships and definitely to professional relationships and for professional successes, because this century is a century of, you know, what do we say, corporate marketing century, and we need to be more communicative in our professional lives. We need to, even for our monthly, you know, raises, our yearly assessments, we need to put in pen and paper, as well as, you know, in our conversation, we need to be very, very communicative. We need to be very courteous and full of etiquettes. Only then we can have fruitful results. Next, our, you know, objective would be to give you an awareness of communication strategies. You know, what could be the way and what could be the things which you would you should take serious concern about communication. Then is analyzing variety of communication acts, which are little, you know, dose of everything I've given you in my PPT, but still would like to, the specialists and the skilled people of these are coming down the line after me in the next 4 days and sharing their personal, both interactive ways as well as in a lecture form. Then, developing confidence through body language. Yes, we have two proficient people in it, and they're going to actually tell you how body language matters most, more even than the words which we speak. And then these days, when we need to deliver messages online or, you know, through pen or emails, how to structure and arrange our presentations. So this, these are our key objectives of this entire workshop on which it has been designed. And last but not the least, thank you so much for listening. And this again in this slide, I would like once again, all of you, please give it a thought. We need to be friendly, we need to be open-minded, and we need to give a patient ear and have confidence, both verbally as well as non-verbally, for our to pass our message or communicate with other people. And feedback is very essential. I have requested, even I would love to have feedback for my session. Thank you very much, all of you. And once again, on behalf of the faculty and principal sir and the management of our college, I welcome all the participants and the resource persons. And I'm closing my lecture on this note that you shall all be eagerly waiting for the next sessions, which are with us for different different resource persons. And we have two people from Canada. One of them shall be, you know, one of them shall be connecting to you tomorrow in two sessions. And she shall be talking about, Madam Jasleen Bindra, she shall be talking about, you know, most of us are in a running module that we need to go to Canada or abroad for our next generation and, you know, for a better prospects. So she's going to talk about the communication problems in the people of, in the immigrant people of Canada. So thank you so much. Signing off to you, ma'am. Madam Asha Rana, please carry on. Thank you.
Hello, 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 Jindan. Thank you so much.